No foul. Crowd locked to a back post. Mills brings it down, shoots and he puts it over.
Welcome to Greg Mills, Stourbridge's number 11 left winger. It's his second interview for me today, and we're going to start with the first question now. You said in your last Q&A your first ever team was Ibstock Tigers. How did you go from Ibstock to Derby County? How did getting in the academy come about?
Oh, I would have been about 11 years old. And we was playing a team in Leicester called Aylston Park, who were at the top of the league. And we lost 7-0, believe it or not. We lost 7-0. And a scout was there. And he went up to my mum and granddad and said, he's from Derby, don't want to go and have a trial. They asked me. I said, yeah. Went on a trial. And I remember on my first training session there, I was looking around. And I was like, wow, these players are amazing. Like, he could just do stuff that I couldn't even do. But I kept on working, kept on improving, and then luckily I got signed.
Yeah. 10 or so clubs later, you ended up at Stourbridge where we met. Your first season was a success with 20-odd goals from left wing. Unfortunately, we fell short of the promotion. Shortly into the start of this last season, you left. Was there any other clubs interested? And was Bromsgrove an easy choice, linking back up with Leon and Mikey Taylor?
Yeah, there was quite a few clubs interested, to be honest. I just wanted to go somewhere where I was happy. At the time of me leaving Stourbridge, I wasn't enjoying it. It was hard to leave because I only have good memories of Stourbridge, hence why I ended up coming back. But I knew I had to leave for personal reasons, for me personally, it was the best decision to leave. Obviously, speaking to Mikey and Leon made it easy, and obviously speaking to Bren, the manager, as well, made it easier. I enjoyed my time there. It's a good club, and it's got some really good people behind the scenes and some really good lads. But yeah, it was a hard decision to leave, but the Stourbridge I left wasn't the Stourbridge that I remember from the season before, unfortunately.
How was it meeting back up with Leon and Mikey then?
I've known Mikey years. Me and Mikey go way back to when we was young pups, me and Mikey. So it was good to play with Mikey again. I enjoyed my time with him at Stourbridge, and I think one of the reasons he come Stourbridge is because I was there. And then Leon's become, since I met Leon when I first joined Stourbridge, and he's become a really close friend, and I've got a lot of time for him and his family. Great people. So it was really good to play again, and there's nothing better, as you know, playing with your friends, to be honest.
Next question. You and Mikey formed a really good partnership at Bromsgrove instead of Stourbridge. How many goals did you both end up with?
Oh, well, he ended up... Because the thing is, I passed to Mikey. Mikey doesn't pass to me, so he ended up with more than me. But I think between us, we got over 40, I think, between us. I remember when we joined, I'm not saying the reason Bromsgrove did well because of me and Mikey, but... I think me and Mikey did help the situation. I think when we joined, we were 19th. And when the season got null and void, I think we were 4th. So we enjoyed a successful time there.
Was you happy with your goal tally last season?
Last season? No, not really, no. Like, I wanted to score more. I want to be the top scorer in the league. I want to score as many as I can. Did I manage to achieve that? No. But was my return on the amount of games I played and the assists included, was I happy with that? Yeah. But the season, obviously, is it going this season now? Is it going ahead? Is it not? Is it? We don't know yet. But if we do go back ahead or next season, then I want even more goals than I've already got at the minute.
Yeah, you didn't get as many goals because the season was cut, really.
Exactly. So my last full season, I got 25 goals. So if anybody asked me, what did you get last season? The last season that actually finished, I got 25. That was the season with Gary Hackett.
Yeah. This season, you returned to Stourbridge for a second time. How did it come about? Was it an easy choice to get? And again, was there any other clubs interested?
Yeah, again, there was quite a few clubs interested. A couple of clubs in the league above. But was it an easy choice? Yes and no. Would I have necessarily gone to any other club in this league? No, I wouldn't. As soon as I knew Stourbridge was interested and I spoke to the gaffer, I knew I had unfinished business. So when I say unfinished business, I didn't. I wanted to leave the club if I was ever going to leave getting promoted. I want to get this club promoted. I want to help get this club promoted. It's a club that should be promoted. It's a club that's close to my heart. So was it an easy decision to leave Bromsgrove? No, because I enjoyed it there. But I'm happy to be back, definitely. And like I say, we've got some really good lads. And the gaffer, I get on really well with him and his backroom staff, Gavin, Neil. So hopefully when we do get back going again, we can push on.
You started this season brightly and won Player of the Month September. Then you picked up an injury. Was it hamstring?
Yeah.
How was the injury after the rest?
Yeah, obviously I've had months to rest. So my hamstring's fine. I just want to get back. I think all the lads, to be fair, when we speak, we all still speak and we're all still in touch. We all just want to get back going. We know towards the end, before it finished, we was disappointed with how things were going. We did have some injuries, but as a squad, we were disappointed. I know. As a whole club, we were disappointed. And we know now we've got the injuries back. We've got a good, strong squad that we can push on. And we've got a point to prove to lots of people.
These questions about this season's squads, as I haven't interviewed anyone this season yet.
Okay.
Manager's pet.
Manager's pet. If you ask somebody else, they might say me. But I think, but probably some of the lads would say me, but I think Martin Riley, maybe.
Yeah. Fastest player.
Fastest? I'm trying to think. Oh, wow. I don't know. Over 5-10 yards, I'd like to back myself. Over 100 yards. I'm not actually 100% sure. I think we might have to do a race. I'm not actually 100% sure on that.
Most aggressive player?
Most aggressive? Yeah. From this season? Yeah. I'd say, obviously, when Birchie was there, Birchie would be up there. Ellis has got a little bit about him. Kieran Morris will just put his head anywhere. Even if he can kick it, he'd rather head it. I'd say one of them three.
Okay. Who works the hardest?
Me. No, I'm only joking. Greeny. I think Greeny.
Most skillful.
I'd like to put myself on there, but we have got some, like, if you want tricks, as in flicking the ball up and things like that, Ellis has got a little bit. Knightsy's got a little bit about him as well. So yeah.
Mr. Grumpy.
Mr. Grumpy. I know sometimes it can be me again. It's as like all these questions about me, but it can be me sometimes. Ellis, yeah. Ellis, I'd say Ellis, actually.
What about Ellis, isn't there?
Yeah, I'd say Ellis.
The Voice.
I'd say Martin Riley, probably. Martin Riley, he's not the loudest as in bellowing, but when he talks, everybody listens.
Many people know we have an ongoing bet between Liverpool and Spurs. They have met 7 times since we started the bet, and Liverpool have won 7 times. How do you feel about that?
I feel, look, I should have said before the interview, any Tottenham questions right now, I don't want to answer, because I'm fragile at the minute about Tottenham. But all I do know is, since I've met you, Tottenham haven't won.
No.
And I think before
too good.
Before I met you, Tottenham were winning, so...
Yeah, you beat us 4-1 or something. Yeah,
you've cursed me. I think you've cursed me and my team, to be honest. So I'm blaming you. So until we win, I'm blaming you.
If you had to pick Harry Kane or Roberto Firmino to partner you up front, who would you pick and why?
Harry Kane, hands down. Harry Kane.
I just knew it.
I think deep down you'd take Harry Kane as well. Because I just think, me personally, Harry Kane scores more goals, which from my striker is what I want. And also this season he's shown that he can also get the assists and the link-up play that Firmino has. What about you? Who would you rather?
Definitely Firmino. No way, having Harry Kane.
Blinkers. That's called blinkers. That's what that is.
If you had to pick Ben Davies or Andy Roberts to play behind you, who would you pick?
See, that's not a fair comparison.
You've got to say it.
That's like me saying, would you rather have Kane or Origi? But, I've got to go Robertson. Ben Davies is on my hit list of Tottenham players that need to get to leave at the minute.
Yeah. You've got that other one over there as well.
Regulon's all right, but again, Robertson, I think you could, I think Robertson's probably... He's one of the best in the world at the minute.
If you had to pick Ben O'Landon or Jordan Brown to play behind you, who would you pick?
Oh, see, you can't do that. No, you can't do that. I love them both. Me and Ben go way back. Me and Brownie are good friends. I've enjoyed many times with both of them. And I'd happily look behind me and I've got Brownie or Ben O'Landon behind me.
First name you had on a football shirt?
I had David Beckham, closely followed by Jermaine Defoe. I remember I got a David Beckham one, and then Jermaine Defoe got in the England squad, and I desperately wanted Jermaine Defoe.
Best goal you've scored any team?
There's a couple. There was one that I scored for Telford where I ran from my own half, well, near enough in my own box, and scored.
There's Andy Sinton of Telford and Graham Turner of the Shrewsbury Town box. Mills now has a chance to run down his left wing. He's got the fresh legs. Mills shoots! Great goal from Greg Mills! He beats Joe Annion and his near push. He cuts in from a wide position on the left. And Greg Mills announces his arrival at Telford with a screamer. Is there going to be late?
It wasn't caught on camera. One of the games that wasn't caught on camera last year, Gary Hackett year, it was the last game of the season, or one of the last games of the season. We played Kings Lynn. And I remember chesting it and volleying. We lost 2-1. I remember chesting it and volleying it because I was too tired to run. And it went into the top corner. And the free kick this year was a good one against Hensford. I was happy with that.
Oh, yeah, that free kick. Yeah
I was happy with that.
Best goal you've scored for Stourbridge?
Either that chest volley, but I haven't got that on video, so I can't, other than in my memory, it was a good goal. But I'd have to say the free kick. I was happy with that one.
Favourite moment in football?
Probably my proudest moment was when I made my debut, because that's something for Derby against Middlesbrough, because that's something that I'd worked on for years. But my favourite, probably the moment that I've enjoyed and actually been really a part of and something really special is we won the league at Corby on the last game of the season against a team that were actually top. And I managed to score in that as well. And we won the league. So that was really good. I've had lots of good moments, and I've met many, many good people, which is even also important.
Best away ground to play at?
Best away ground to play at? I enjoy going to Tamworth, because I get the fans there. I used to play for them, so I get a little bit of a stick from them, but this year when we played them, when I was getting stick and then I scored, they were very, very quiet. But it's good, it's good banter. When they beat us on penalties again, I started getting stick. But again, it's good banter. So I do enjoy going to that one.
Yeah.
But to be fair, the Bromsgrove one would have been interesting. I was looking forward to that one this year. Bromsgrove away, because when we played there, when I was at Starbridge, it was good to play at. But obviously now there's a little bit more added edge between the amount of players that have gone to and from both teams. So I think that would have been a good one.
Yeah. Favourite sport other than football?
Favourite sport other than football? I watch quite a bit of American football. I don't watch it as much as I used to. I like basketball, American football. To play, if it was me to play though, my work's got a table tennis, so I've been taking up table tennis in my spare time.
Funny story from the dressing room at any club.
Oh, what that I can tell you on here? Yeah. Funny story. I was at Telford, and we played Kidderminster away, and we had a guy called Dan Preston. I think he might have been at Starbridge actually for a little bit. Because I know a couple of the lads know him. So Dan Preston is one of the angriest men I've ever met in football. And he's playing Kidderminster, and a guy called Jamal Matt. There's a term in football called bullied him. So he just kept on getting it on his chest, and manager's come in and he's gone, "Prezzo, why is he bullying you?" Prezzo sat there, started tapping his leg. He's only got one boot on because I think he's icing his foot. Like his other foot. And in the Kidderminster away dressing room, it's like brick underneath. It's like painted brick. So it's quite slippy in boots, especially when you've got studs on. And he's got up, shouted, "I've not been getting bullied." He's kicked this bin that where you put all the kit in the middle of the changing room and just gone flying because it's so slippy on his boot. And he's just gone flying in the middle. And I wanted to laugh. But it's about 3-0 down, so I couldn't really laugh. But in my head, I was laughing so much. And then after the game, I remember just ringing him and just burst out laughing. But yeah, I think that's one of our funniest moments.
Yeah. Call someone else out for my Q&As.
Call someone else out. I think I'm going to pick you someone you haven't done yet. I think I'm going to get onto Ellis, which I think will be a good one, or Mikey Taylor to get on one of these. I think they'll be two good ones. So I'll try and sort that out for you.
Yeah. Is GM coaching coming back this summer?
Yeah, it is coming back this summer. Obviously, there's a lot of things going on at the minute. We have to be really careful with social distancing and things like that. So when it starts up, I want to start it up properly. So yeah, it's just when hopefully things get to back a little bit more normal, we'll get it going again.
Pick an 11-a-side team from your whole time to Stalbridge.
Oh, wow. Wow. Right, 11-a-side team. I've got to go.
Formation then, first.
Say again, sorry.
Formation.
Formation. I'm going to go 4-2-3-1. Okay, that just means that I can get the players in I want to get off the top of Actually, I'm going to go 4-4-2. I've got to go 4-4-2. Let me think. I'll come back to formation. Let me pick the players first. So I'm going to pick the people on how I've played with them at Stourbridge rather than what I know, because I've played with a couple of the lads away from Stourbridge and they've been absolutely excellent. But I know it's some of the lads. So I'm going to just basically pick them at how they've been when they've played for Stourbridge and what I've seen of them at Stourbridge. So I'm going to have, even though Charlie's done brilliant when I've played with him, I think Rennie for that season was different class. I remember thinking, I never actually knew, and I've had this conversation with Rennie, so he knows what I mean. And I never knew, and I don't think anybody really knew how good Rennie was, because he didn't really have to make that many saves. But when he did, every save was brilliant. And then the season after, under Ian Long, I remember seeing it, some of the saves he made, and I was like, wow. So I think for me, Rennie, right back, I think it's got to be Greeny. I think I've played against Greeny. I've played with Greeny. Mr. Consistent, you know what you're going to get from Greeny. So yeah, Greeny. Centre backs, I'm going to pick Aaron Hayden. Obviously, he's gone on to do brilliant things, and I think at the time he played, he was a man mountain, and I think we really missed him when he left. Centre backs, the other centre back, I thought Maka was good. I like Maka, but I'm going to pick Stu Pearpoint, just because he'll ring me if not. But Stu, in all fairness, Stu was brilliant. Especially on that left hand side, he was, and every time I've played against him since, I don't know how he does it, because it is age, I won't be able to run anywhere. But no, Stu, left back, I've got to go Brownie again. That season he was fantastic, and Brownie as a player is unbelievable. In midfield, I'm gonna go 40. Fordy's a winner. I respect Fordy so much. He's vocal, he works hard, he's good on the ball, and you've only got to look what he's gone and done at Tamworth, and Tamworth are right up there and a strong team, and he only makes them better. Over midfield, I'm gonna add Leon. Leon, obviously, what he's done for the club, you probably could tell me more than what I know. I can only judge him on what I've seen, and he gets goals, he's a leader, he's a top man, and yeah, he leads by example. Can I put myself in there, just because I'd like to play in this team?
It's great, yeah.
Yeah, so I'm going to put myself in there. On the left, I'm going to have, on the right, I'm going to go Cayman. I think Cayman, so underrated in my eyes, the stuff that he did do. Top lad again. You sit next to him in the change room, very funny guy. But yeah, I really enjoyed playing with Cayman. I like playing with him. In the number, in just behind the striker, I am going to pick Bembo. And even though Bembo, I know Bembo is a striker, I am going to pick Bembo, because he's got the passing, he's got the shooting, and
got the
Bembo, Free kicks. Bembo's free kicks was like a penalty. I remember the first couple I used to run in for, thinking, oh, I might get the rebound here. And then after it, I just thought, there's no point. It's going in. And again, what a top player, top lad as well. And definitely one of the best strikers I've played with throughout my career. Some of the stuff I've seen him do, I'm just like, wow. And up front, I'm going to pick Mikey Taylor. I do think, even though I didn't play with him long at Stourbridge, the time when he did play, he was scoring goals. I think he would have scored a lot of goals. And I enjoyed doing it. And I think Mikey Taylor can do all my running. Kamen and Mikey can do all mine and Bembo's running. So I think we'll be all right.
Who's the manager? Hackett, Longy or Yates?
Oh, no. You can't.
You're going to cross out Longy, yeah?
You said that, not me.
Longy was all right, but...
I played longer under Gary Hackett.
Yes.
So I've got to pick Gary Hackett because I played longer under Gary Hackett. But
I
genuinely enjoy playing for the Gaffer now. And I do think if when we come back, I do think there will be a massive improvement with how we ended. So I'm going to have Gary Hackett as manager with Mark Yates as assistant manager.
Before we end, I would just like to say a thanks to you for the time and support you've given me since we met. I really appreciate it.
No, it's been brilliant, mate. Like I say, from when we first met, you're fantastic. You're a massive part of the football club. That's not just to me. That's to everybody. And I was so excited, even though I couldn't tell you I was coming back, just to say, look, I'm coming back. And I know all the lads genuinely look out for you when we come out onto the pitch, mate. So keep doing what you're doing. Fantastic job. The whole club appreciates you. All the lads appreciate you. And you'll grow up to be a fantastic young man.
Thank you, Millsy, for letting me interview you today.
No problem, mate.
Please like and share my videos and subscribe to my channel, Charlie Footy 11.